Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. Get a
lose your enthusiasm and energy now. Have a song, Dan?
479 in the blue book.
479 in the blue book. Softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling.
Thank you.
you envision worship services during the time of the Apostle Paul?
Long.
Loud.
Are you talking about the time that the guy fell asleep in the upstairs window and fell out?
Probably.
Do you remember what his name was?
Oh, no.
It's easy to remember. You want to give you a way that you can remember his name so that you never forget it?
I don't say never forget because I forget a lot.
Well, his name, somebody told me this years ago. His name was Eutychus. And the way that you remember it, if that had been you that fell out of that upstairs window, Eutychus too. No.
Okay.
All right. Bad illustration. Bad illustration. But maybe it will help to cement it in your mind. You think it might help? I thought, well, yeah, it'll probably kind of stick with people. But we don't ever want to cuss. No. You'd better not cuss. So, yes, they could be long, but in all seriousness, what do you envision?
Didn't they stand?
What was that?
When the Word of God was read, didn't they stand?
Well, I personally think, yeah, in the synagogues and stuff, we read back, I think it's in the book of Ezra, you know, that when Ezra got ready to read, the people all stood because they didn't have individual copies of the Word of God, and the people stood out pouring rain. I mean, it was one of those things that they had respect for the Word of God. I'm envisioning a lot of the churches that kind of the Apostle Paul helped get started. They were small and they met in homes, house churches. Tonight we'll talk some about the church that apparently was meeting at the home of Philemon in the city of Colossae. And I can envision it just being a small gathering of people. And the reason I'm saying that is because here we are just a few in number, while the world outside just goes about their activities. And quite honestly, that's the way it was when the Apostle Paul, I think, was getting started. I don't believe that everywhere he went that he had great numbers of people. You know, oftentimes he would just start with a few people, like when he went to Philippi and he met with Lydia and, you know, down at the river. I could just envision them kind of being little small gatherings of people, and I couldn't help but think as I drove to church tonight, seeing people outside doing whatever. Most people, there's just absolutely no thought of what's going on. But as for me and my house, we'll serve the Lord. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go to the house of the Lord and to worship the Lord. So I'm just kind of curious what went through your mind when you thought about, have any of you ever been part of little mission churches that got started? Maybe in a storefront or people's home? You shaking your head. Would you like to tell us anything about it there, Joe?
Yes. When we first started going to church, we were not saved. We were Smiths. Wilbur and Virginia Smith held services in their home. That's how it got started. And then as time went on and they were growing, they built a building. To become independent Bible church.
Okay.
And that's when Benny and I both got saved.
Okay. Now you said that they met in the people's home. They just invited you to come in and everybody had a seat on the sofa or?
No, they set up chairs.
Okay, they set up chairs.
Chairs, yeah.
Okay.
Moved the furniture back against the wall.
Okay, did they sing songs back then? Mm-hmm. You know, time of singing songs? Did they have song books?
Don't remember. I think they did, yes.
Okay. Well, just kind of curious, picking your brains. So thanks for being here at the Lord's house tonight. And do be in prayer for us this week as we launch this children's program.
And the same day we launch that program, you can drive across the new bridge.
That's on Wednesday, isn't it? Yeah.
Change?
On the 20th.
You can't drive across.
Oh, can't drive, okay.
You crossed it till the next day.
Okay, yeah. Can't drive across.
The ceremony's Wednesday. Then you can drive across it Thursday.
Okay. So, big week in the Ohio Valley. Big week. I thought about one other prayer request. I talked with Lawrence Kimball this past week. He stopped by my house. saw that I was doing yard sale, and he said that Miss Pat was having surgery on her foot, I think it was. So.
How much jumpers, I mean, stuff did you sell?
Quite a bit, but not nearly enough. Got a lot more stuff to get rid of. So, yeah, I did all right. I was happy with what I was able to get rid of, but not nearly enough stuff. So, still got my work cut out for me.
When you put the guns out, let me know.
Okay. Yeah. Thankfully, they don't take up a lot of room. That's one thing that's kind of taught me through this whole experience. If you're buying stuff that's bargains, don't buy big stuff. It takes up a lot of room.
Yeah. So you're selling the tabletop?
No. No, I got stuff stored on it, so.
Maybe if it had legs, you would have sold it.
Maybe so.
Yeah.
She's referring to a tabletop that I bought years ago. It was beautiful. And
I mean, years ago.
Oh, it's got to be 20 years ago.
Yeah.
But I said, I know the plans I have for you.
Yeah.
Anyhow, taking a look at the prayer request list, are there any additional ones, like I said, Pat Kimball, if you just keep her in prayer? And then I also, I think you were the one that was maybe telling me, Sherry, about Melanie Glover.
No, I haven't talked to him for a while.
Who was it that was telling me that, I think that, if I'm not mistaken, they said that she was diagnosed with breast cancer? Mm. And there was...
I don't know.
Yeah.
I know on the grieving families, we need to put the McAllisters on there.
McAllister?
Yeah.
Anybody else?
I thought I heard a car door.
Or the back door.
Something.
Did the back door locked?
Somebody in that family died.
Yeah, the back door was locked.
Yes.
Oh, I didn't know that.
I know. It took... And I can't believe how many kids was in that family.
Wow. Sheila, go look.
There was a bunch of them.
Yeah. There's quite a few of them gone, and still quite a few.
Was Charlie sick or?
I don't know. It's. I just seen his obituary and I was like.
That they already buried him or?
No, not yet. Hmm. I know he's going to be up here at James's.
Who died?
Charlie McAllister. Okay. You know who I'm talking about? The McAllisters? That's a big family.
Oh my goodness, yes.
I went to school with him.
And he worked out at the coal mine. Worked out there with my brother for years. Actually, him and his couple of his brothers.
Okay. Well, let's pray for these. Father, we do want to say thank you for the blessings that you've given us, and thankful for our health and our strength and our ability to be here tonight. And we do thank you for answers to prayers. I shared this morning, there were several people that we were just giving thanks, Father, for what you've done. But as we've come together tonight, we just want to say about all those that we've got printed in the bulletin, as well as these additional names that we've added, we're lifting them to you and asking your blessing to comfort the McAllister family. We're heartbroken to hear of their loss. And just pray, Father, that they might sense your nearness, that you might comfort them as they adjust to the loss of their loved one. The same could be said about the Ennis family that we added this morning. And Father, the Miller family, the man that just lives up the road, passed away. So every day our lives are, you know, coming in contact with people that have suffered loss. And we do pray, Father, that you'll comfort those that have heavy hearts. Please bless them and encourage them to keep looking up and to keep faith and trust in you. If they don't know you, pray that they might come to know you. We pray that you might meet with the people with all sorts of physical needs. And I know that I mentioned Pat Kimball, and just pray, Father, that the surgery would go well for her. And if it's not already been done, we just pray, Father, that you'd help her heal quickly. We pray for the Glover family. They have been through so much. And we just ask you, Lord, to please meet the health needs of Melanie, as well as the emotional needs as well. As we said, they've suffered a lot of loss.
Father, we pray that you'll be with some others that we put on the prayer list this morning, like Ms. Schaefer, that's having the knee replacement this week. We just pray that that's going to go well. And there were some others. I can't keep everything straight, but Lord, we just ask that you'd meet people's needs. And we again pray, Father, that you might revive us as your people. And it's not just us, but your people everywhere. Pray that there can be a massive turning back to you. We pray that our country can get turned around, that we might understand that we really do need to serve you and to follow your instruction. We pray that the lost might be convicted, that Father, your Spirit, and Lord, you're the one that said, nobody comes to Father except the Father draws them. We just pray that your Spirit might be speaking to people's hearts and that you'll give us boldness to tell people they need to come to faith in Jesus Christ if they want to be saved. And again, Father, we just pray that you'd even meet unspoken needs. We need your help with those things that even we don't talk about, except maybe with you. We pray that you'd help us with those areas. Again, help our country to get turned back to you. Pray that our leaders might understand that they need to follow your instructions, and if they don't, they're just going to bring more problems upon all of us. We also pray, Father, that you'll be with our military and law enforcement and keep them safe. And we pray that you will bless the Bible study tonight. Later on this week, as we start this children's after-school program, we pray that you might bless it, that it might be effective in ministering to, you know, the needs of not only the kids, but their families, and pointing them to you. Because, Father, we desperately need you. So, again, bless this time and guide us in everything that we say and do that will honor you. Forgive us when we fail you. We love you. And if there are any requests that I overlooked, Father, I just pray that you'll meet those as well. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Joe, 11 to 1 tomorrow.